joining 11th class. I hope you are safe at your home, right? Today we will discuss about our next plant phylum is the Gymnosperm. Gymnosperm, as the name indicates, Gymnosperm have seed production. Seeds are nape type of seeds. It means we cannot see the seeds of Gymnosperm from the nape dies, as well as they do not produce fruits because ovary is absent in case of Gymnosperm. Generally, the Gymnosperms are all type of biennial, perennial type of plants actually, and because they are developed as compared to the pteridophyte, bryophytes and algae, so they have a well developed root, shoot and leaf system. And if you compare, these are the phanerogames actually, because they produce the seeds. Their seeds are small in size, but because they produce seeds, so they are undergo the phanerogames. And remaining three, which we had already discussed, the algae, the bryophyta, the pteridophyta, they are included into the cryptogames because seeds are absent in that condition, right? Gymnosperms have a taproot system, as well as they show a special kind of character is called the symbiotic association. They are generally the herb, shrub, trees, all type of tree forms are present in case of the Gymnosperm. And symbiotic association generally in the cycas plant, where the a fungus is called the mycorrhiza, which is stay in the root of the cycas plants. The mycorrhiza has a large size of hyphae, which actually absorb the nutrients from the soil. Because the cycas roots are very small in size, taproot system is present, so the absorption takes place by the hyphae of the mycorrhiza, and with the help of these absorption, the cycas leaves produce the food by the photosynthesis, and this food is also given to the mycorrhiza fungus. So this association, where both get benefit from each other, this kind of association is called the symbiotic association simply, right? Any other thing about the Gymnosperms? Their leaves are dimorphic type, and their leaves have capability to survive in a humid or a temperate environment. For example, the pinus plant have a needle-like leaves actually, because they can survive in a very low temperature also. And cycas have a branch or branch kind of structure, and their leaves are generally furcated type of, to survive in a humid and high temperature condition simply, right? Their leaves are dimorphic. It means two type of leaves are present. These leaves are called the sporophyllous. They have two type of sporophyllous, microsporophyllous and megasporophyllous. If we will talk about the vascular bundles, the xylem and phloem are present, but in case of xylem, vessels are absent, and in case of phloem, the companion cells and the sieve tubes are absent in case of phloem, right? But they show the secondary growth. Secondary growth is present in the xylem and phloem in case of the Gymnosperms, right? Okay, next is they have a thick, one more important feature of the Gymnosperm, they have a thick cuticle, sunken stromata. Actually, these stromatas open during the day, night time, and close during the daytime, because they are survive in a humid environment also, some Gymnosperm. So they have a special type of stromata called the sunken stromata, right? Crunch anatomy is present in the Gymnosperm. Next is the spores actually produced. They produce the spores. If we will discuss about the reproduction, spores are present in a special body is called the sporangia. There are two type of spores are present, the microspores and megaspores. Microspores actually produce the male gamete, and megaspores produce the female gamete. They have a special type of structure. The microsporophyll is called the cone or strobili. If the cone or strobili are present in the different plants, for example, the male cone and female cone, they call the respectively male cone and female cone when both are present in the different plant. Generally, the lifespan of male strobili is less or short-lived as compared to the female. Female have a large lifespan. Male cone actually produce the male gametes. These male gametes do not have a motility property. It means they are non-motile in nature. So water is required for the transmission, but they are produced in a large number. Motility is not produced. It means they cannot move. There is no any flagellant cilia is present in case of male gamete simply, right? Female gamete is large in size, that's why it's called the megaspore as compared to the microspore, right? Pollination, if we will discuss about the pollination, pollination is generally occur with the help of wind. Anemophilus is present in case of the gymnosperm. Wind actually help in the transmission of male gamete, because male gametes are non-motile, to the female tract. In case of gymnosperm, there is no neck canal cell and ventral canal cell is present in case of the female, and siphonogamy kind of fertilization takes place in that gymnosperm. It means pollen tube is arise from the tube, male gamete goes into the female tract, same in the angiosperm, same as the angiosperm. But the triple fusion and double fertilization does not takes place in case of the gymnosperms. One more thing about the gymnosperm is that the development of endosperm actually takes place before the fertilization, but in case of angiosperm, endosperm is produced during the fertilization. But here the development of endosperm, we actually, in case of angiosperm, firstly endosperm is produced, then the development takes place after the fertilization. But here before fertilization, the development of endosperm takes place. Double fertilization, triple fusion does not take place. In a gymnosperm, there is a more, you can say that the condition is that the polyembryony is formed. Polyembryony condition is present in case of the gymnosperm. It means more than two embryos are formed. Fruit formation does not take place in the gymnosperm because ovary is absent and seeds are produced naked size, means we cannot see from the naked eye simply. So these are the features of the gymnosperm. All about the gymnosperm, we have a last topic about the angiosperm, which we will discuss in our next lecture of the plant kingdom. After the angiosperm, plant kingdom has been completed. Thank you.